Artist workflows in virtual production include the flow of assets between digital content creation tools and Unreal Engine. Digital content creation tools, or DCCs, refer primarily to the software in which assets are created or modified before they are imported into Unreal Engine and assembled into final virtual scenes. While Unreal Engine does include some basic tools for creating and modifying digital assets, productions rely on dedicated DCC software that offers a far wider range of editing features. Commonly used DCC software includes Autodesk Maya or Blender for 3D modeling, animation, and rigging, Adobe Substance 3D and Substance Painter for texturing and surfacing, and Houdini for simulation effects. While these programs are some of the most popular, virtual productions may use a wide variety of other DCC software according to the needs of the production, established workflows, and the skill sets of the team members. The chart here shows an example of a full CG virtual production with no live performance, and how these previously mentioned steps fit together. The whole digital content creation process, from pre-visualization all the way to the final assembled scene, falls under the umbrella of the Virtual Art Department, or VAD team. Throughout the VAD process, digital assets must pass from DCC software into Unreal for final assembly. VAD begins with pre-vis, asset, and scene building. Assets pass through a variety of steps on their way to completion, many of which are performed in different DCC software. 3D assets are first modeled and then surfaced, meaning textures are created and applied. Animated assets are rigged to create skeletons and weights. Animation for characters may be done by hand in a DCC like Maya, captured through motion capture, or a combination of both. These assets and animations are brought into Unreal, where a layout artist assembles the scene, and final scene look development is performed. Final camera tracks are created, and the scene is rendered. All VAD work primarily occurs within this box, and includes work done in dedicated DCC software, as well as Unreal. This graphic shows a closer look at the flow of these assets between DCC and Unreal that occurs within the box in the previous graphic. Assets may be blocked out in Unreal, created at a high resolution in DCCs like Maya or Blender, passed to another DCC like Substance Painter for surfacing, and then brought back into Unreal for final scene assembly. At each step of this process, versions of each of these assets, as well as the project files from DCCs, such as a Maya project file, must be saved and tracked. For each digital asset, including textures and project files, you may have up to 10 or more files that must be managed. Because of this, source control, like that provided by Helix Core, is essential to tracking and managing files and making sure everyone is working on the latest version, both in your Unreal project and for the assets and project files created outside of it. With potentially thousands of assets and tens of thousands of asset files, for even a mid-sized project, foregoing source control could easily throw your production into chaos if assets are lost, work is overwritten, or wrong versions are used. Helix Sync, which we will explore in the next section, is a great option for artists to work with these assets outside of the Unreal project.